throw it?
When we're done, you're gonna see this baby come to life. So the fly I'm gonna tie today, I really can't take credit for, but it's kind of cool that I can't take credit for it because the idea came from one of my subscribers. He sent me this. Honestly, I think this is the first care package that somebody has sent me. He's an awesome tier. He ties excellent. His name is Joshua, and I'll see if he wants me to link his Instagram and stuff below, and you guys could go follow him. But I'm just so thrilled with these flies, guys. Let me just show them to you. But Joshua, thank you. I sincerely appreciate you, my friend. Pray the good Lord blesses you for your kindness. This is what inspired me to tie the fly that I'm going to tie today. Look at these jigs he ties. Look at this crappie jig. That is quality work. And here's another. Isn't that cool? He also sent me these, it's kind of a bugger, woolly bugger leech pattern. I mean, that's how I'll fish it. And look at this one. I'll say thank you, Joshua. You are awesome. And everyone that has subscribed to my channel, you guys are awesome. I appreciate every one of you. So let's tie this bug. The hook I'm going to use for this is a fulling mill FM5130 in a size 12. And I am not sponsored by these, so buy whatever hooks you guys like. Nice. And since I don't have any barbell eyes, I've tied with these before. This is just a chain bead necklace. And it's like hundreds of eyes. And you can buy a 12-inch piece of this at the hardware store, or you can get it at a jewelry store, or I'll try to find something that I'll link down below, but it just gives you hundreds of eyes for super cheap. And I'm just gonna cut two of those off. Red, just a 70 denier and a fluorescent orange base layer. Dress the hook. Okay, so now when we fish this fly, we want this fly to ride like this. We want it to invert, hook point up. You get higher hookup ratios and less snags. So we're gonna tie these eyes just right in front of that bend. And I'm just gonna crisscross here. Give you guys a little view there. Going a couple wraps this way. And then I'll switch. And do a few wraps this way. And then I'm gonna show you guys a little hack here. Yeah, just center on the hook. Okay, so when you're wrapping it, one thing you want to do after you get them in position is go under both of them like this. And what that does is that just cranks down your thread wraps and then keeps those from spinning. You can also add a drop of super glue. Then we'll come back to about right there. Okay, so next we're just going to grab some marabou. And I've got some chartreuse here. I wanted to stick out about half the length of the shank, so I'm just going to kind of eyeball it here. And I'll just pinch wrap that. Just loosely wrap that a couple times. I'll check my length. Yeah, that looks good. Let's go ahead and take and we'll trim this off. And we'll just clean this up. Okay, next I've just got some fluorescent orange UV chenille. Pretty much the same thing you'd use for sand one worm. There, and then we'll come back and we'll grab that, tie that in. It's gonna advance our thread forward. Okay, so next we'll grab our chenille, and I'm just gonna use the rotary on the vise and just do touching wraps forward, and we'll just tie that in. Get a couple wraps in front, we'll trim it. So now we're just gonna move our thread back to just where that marabou starts. That position right there. Okay, so next we're gonna grab another piece of chenille, just make a loop like that. So looks something like that. I'm going to tie that in. I'm going to separate them like this. So it should look something like that. Okay, and now we're going to grab some flashy red Christmas ribbon. Just fold that in half like that. I'm gonna tie that right there. Like that. These have, it's important these stay separated for this next step. Get that wrapped in good and tight. What we're gonna do is gonna take the ribbon. We're gonna fold it forward like this. Get a couple wraps in there to hold this baby. It looks terrible now, guys, but when you see, wait till you see this thing finished, it's gonna be crazy. So it should look something like that. We're getting there. Okay, and then so next we're gonna take this diamond braid. You wanna make sure you fold it too. Then we're gonna tie that in. So it should look something like that. I mean, it looks like a big Wachankophyus right now, but when we're done, you're gonna see this baby come to life. Haha, just kidding. Did I get you guys that time? No, you guys are like, Steve's pulling another fast one on us. So now I gotta work 15 minutes to get this all undone so I can finish the real fly. And I think we got it all undone. Oh man, I'm ruining the fly tying world. But you know what? I think people need to laugh more. Okay, so for real. You're gonna grab some diamond braid. This is honestly Christmas ribbon. That was on a gift that my daughter gave me, and I was like, oh, that's diamond braid fly tying gold right there. Sorry. Okay, so what we're gonna do, I want some of these fibers right here about half the length of the tail. Okay, so I'm gonna pinch that right there. And then after I get a wrap in, I'm gonna let go so it flattens out. And this is for real. This is not me pranking you guys. So next, we're going to pull that and get that diamond braid to squeeze between those bead eyes. Like that. We're going to come under. We're going to let that hook eye poke through. And at this point, we have to pinch it, take it out of the vise. Take it out of the vise. Let your thread swing away from the hook, like down. There's the hook point. And then we're just going to kind of thread that through the hook point like that. So all we did is we took it out of the vise and we threaded it through the hook. Now I'm going to put that back in the vise, clamp it down, make sure we got it pretty center. And we will just tie that in. Okay, so then we're gonna take our wonky Walmart scissors. Steve, the diamond ring, okay. Make sure everything is good and square. Get a few more wraps in here. Okay, so after you get all those wraps in, just take, and we're just gonna whip finish it with our hand here. And trimmer thread. Hang in there, don't go, guys. Don't click off. It makes the algorithm rank terrible. And we're gonna take our bodkin and I'm just gonna pick out the tailing fibers of the braid. The marabou is gonna be what really gives it some life. That and jigging it. I'm gonna grab some UV thick cement and we're just going to coat around just the head. This is just going to add some durability and keep that braid nice and uniform. And we'll hit that with the UV light. Boy, look at that thing with the UV. Oh, it's going to be a fish catcher for sure. It's going to turn the fly over. I'm going to do the same thing to this side. hit that with the UV light. And last, you could use the UV, or I've just got some water based here. Whoa, well, it's okay. I'll just give that a drop right on those threads, let it soak in. I think I'm gonna name this the Josh Jig. What do you guys think? In honor of Joshua for sending me the pattern. All right, like that. Make sure you stay tuned to the channel, guys. I do plan on fishing this fly for crappie. I've already got some crappie fly fishing videos up. Again, thank you, Josh, and thank you, everyone, for watching Ice and Sue. We appreciate all of you and hope you have a blessed and wonderful week. Wherever you're at in the world, this is Steve signing out. She wants me to throw it. You want me to throw it?